guys, what's going on? I just got back from an epic fishing trip down in the Keys, and I have my angle cooler full of Wahoo here. Now, before we get to the fishing part of the video, I want to start with a giveaway. Now, I'm going to be giving away two angle coolers, one on my Instagram, so make sure you're following me on my Instagram, at Brookie Chris, and then one on my YouTube channel. To enter the YouTube giveaway, all you have to do is one, be subscribed to me, and two, go to anglecoolers.com. I will have a link in the description. Go there and pick your favorite cooler up to an 80 quart, and then come back to the video, comment down below your favorite cooler and color, what you would like to win, and then I'm gonna pick a winner in a following video. So super simple, let's say you wanted an 80 quart great cooler, just comment down below, hey Brooke, I'd love an 80 quart great cooler, and then just be watching to see if you win. Now Victor and I woke up at 2:30 in the morning yesterday and drove down to the Keys with our friend Elliot to fish with Captain Ryan of Good Karma Sport Fishing. We had an absolutely epic day of fishing. I hope you guys enjoy the video. Now let's get to fishing.
Okay guys, maybe 40 minutes in. First fish hit on the planer, which is down deep. Brooke's reeling it in. Second fish, Elliot's got on the plug. Absolutely beautiful out here, and it's gonna be a good day.
Yeah. Oh, baby.
That's a big one on that bait. Not a big fish on that. I think they're both
awesome. Heck yeah!
Brooke said, I never caught a Wahoo on my own before. Well, that's about to change.
Beautiful morning. Two fish on. I'm in low gear, so that's why I'm cranking so good on this thing.
Let me know if I need to speed up. Gotta keep that tension on him, alright?
Was yours boiling on top?
Mine was. When he hit it, he was a nice fish on top.
You got a big one. I think Brooke's got a big one.
I feel like I'm with two Wahoo experts today.
Well, you kind of are.
I know.
Here he comes, Brooke. Get ready. As soon as I see that leader, girl, you got to pick it up, right?
Okay.
That means you got about another 10 feet on him. If he runs, just get ready to bat. Remember, if the line's not tight, it won't break, okay? Here he comes. Get ready. Why don't you go ahead and get ready to pick that up.
Big fish, big fish.
Nice fish.
Here he comes.
Oh, yes.
Nice striper.
Nice.
Beauty.
Beauty. Yes. Oh. 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 We got it. We broke the gas.
No way.
Real.
You got it.
Oh. Yeah. Yeah.
Gosh.
Oh my gosh! Good
job, girl!
Woohoo! Oh, it's amazing!
On the bait strip, check that out. Woo. Hold on, there's so much water splashed.
Hell yeah! Awesome!
That fish was so green, girl, that he just wasn't ready.
Look at that thing, Brooke,
that's a monster fish, girl.
That is a stud on the bait strip. 35
baby. There we go.
Yeah. Nice. Ah! Oh, sorry for the cut.
Oh my gosh.
Woo!
Oh my gosh.
Woo!
Oh my gosh. 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 Oh my g
thanks to this guy right here.
Yeah, man, I appreciate you guys coming out fishing with me today.
I've never caught a wahoo before. I've been on the boat before when we've caught them, but I've never actually got to reel one in before. Absolutely epic. I caught this big boy, Elliot got this big boy, and we caught it on a bait strip, which is this guy's invention.
Never mind the gaff shots. Fish went crazy, buddy.
Thank you to nice Captain fish. Ryan. Absolutely amazing. We've been fishing for less than an hour. The sun just came up. So awesome.
Congratulations.
Woke up this morning at 2:30. To be honest, I was a little tired, but now I got a ton of adrenaline and I'm super stoked.
Nice. Perfect. Perfect.
Yeah, this is perfect right here.
Let me know what's up. I'm here for you.
I see him.
You guys got him?
Yep.
Paris today, don't we?
Doubles up, baby. This is the third double. Third double of the day. Elliot said his jumped out of the water. I didn't see that.
Aired out for the bay back there.
This thing was smoking the reel.
I think they're both big fish.
Now this is how you catch a wahoo. Not pushing a button on an LP.
Up. I need to speed up, guys.
Elliot, big one?
I feel like a nice one.
That one aired.
Aired out for him.
That one aired out.
Is that on the...
Oh my God.
That's a... I
think
that one's the one.
The one.
Man.
That's the one.
That's the man.
I think that's the one.
Your fish is really pissed off.
So this was on a plug. And then Elliot's was on the downrigger? Or no? No, his was on the ballyhoo?
His ate the long. It ate the shotgun. Let me know what to do with the boat here, where he's going.
Yeah, we're good.
Right,
we're good. We're good right here.
How's the speed?
It's perfect. Here, gaff is my fish.
Oh, hell yes!
Oh my God.
Get him out of the way so we can help her out. Yeah, you got a big one.
Crazy, look at this!
You got a giant, bro.
Bro, it's a
that's
giant.
That's not a little leader there.
Look!
How's the drag? It's still tight, right? Oh yeah, you're good. You're doing just fine. Oh man.
Elliot! Come on, gaff shot of the year, let's go. No pressure, bro.
Oh my God!
Hit it! Hit it! Yeah!
Woo! Look at that thing! Awesome gaff job too!
Woo-hoo! Good job, brother. Stand up, girl.
Woo-hoo!
Beautiful!
Stand up.
Now, Brooke,
That wasn't reeling in the rod holder at all. That was me holding it the whole time. Look at that.
That is the best
color. On a plug. Check that out. He's not as big as the first one that I caught, but that was awesome.
But that one fought. He had a lot of spunk in him.
Yeah, he did.
Bro, that was a hell of a fight, bro.
That thing pulled a lot harder.
I'll stand. Yeah, that thing pulled hard.
Let's see. I hit him in the head the first time it came out.
Look right here.
Hold that thing up, babe.
Baby.
Epic, babe. So what do you think? You went from catching zero wahoo to two in one day.
Absolutely epic. I couldn't have asked for a better day. That was so awesome. This is our third double. It's not like we were catching singles or anything. Our third double. So awesome. Woo!
I couldn't ask for a better looking fillet table than this. Look at those torpedoes.
Add a little bit of different flavor in there with the yellow jack and a little black fin. Look at that. Beautiful.
Yeah, look at that meat. It's so gorgeous.
Alright guys, we had an absolutely epic day on the water. Like I had said, I had never actually caught a wahoo before. And look at this, we got six of them today. We missed a couple, but six was our limit for the three of us. We're gonna take these home with us and we're gonna fillet these guys up and have an epic sushi party and make a ton of different things. But I wanna give a huge shout out to Captain Ryan for taking us out today. And I'm gonna have him tell you guys a little bit about the charters that he does down here in the Keys.
Hey guys. My specialties are reef and wreck fishing, yellowtail snapper, grouper, mutton snapper when they're biting. And if I do a lot of wahoo fishing. And summertime, it's dolphin, muttons. And in the wintertime, when it's windy, it's patchery fishing. Ultralight tackle, super fun for the family and anybody who just likes to bend the rod and catch some dinner. Please give me a follow on Instagram at goodkarmasportfishing_FL_keys. And my website for information on prices and fishing reports is goodkarmasportfishing.com.
And he also has a podcast.
And my podcast. Yes, I can't forget about my podcast. I have a weekly podcast that launches on Wednesdays and Saturdays. So a tackle tip and a longer podcast airs on Wednesday. Lots of stuff on there. So get caught up on them. I'll tell you how I catch these wahoo.
He's got it all dialed in here, so if you guys are ever looking for a charter in the Florida Keys, definitely check him out. I will have all of his information linked down in the description, and I will meet you guys back home to fillet these up. Hey guys, welcome back to the kitchen. Now, I told you I was gonna go... Hey guys, welcome back to the kitchen. Now, I told you I was gonna meet you at the fillet table, but I didn't end up filleting any of the wahoo. Victor filleted it all, so if you wanna watch him fillet one, check out his video. I will have it linked down in the description. Now we are in the kitchen and we're making sushi. I've already made, I think, 15 rolls of sushi. So I'm gonna show you guys what I'm doing here. I'm literally like shaking.
You're doing good.
Oh, and by the way, I have an audience, so.
You're doing good.
Okay, so. Here's our seaweed roll. Now there's a shiny side and a dull side. You wanna put the shiny side down. And now I'm gonna show you my little tips for doing this. You're gonna need a bamboo roll that looks like this. And then I like to put it in a plastic bag because you don't want your bamboo roll getting a bunch of rice inside the cracks and everything. So put it in a Ziploc bag. Then you need a piece of saran wrap, plastic cling wrap, anything like that. That's gonna go down on your bamboo, on your plastic bag. Then you take your seaweed, shiny side down. And now if you look, there's like creases in the seaweed. You want to roll with the creases, not against the creases. So pay attention to that too. Now I have rice. Victor and I always used to make rice on the stovetop, but we invested in this rice cooker today. So that's what we did. Put some sushi rice on here. Now the next tip I have for you is you need to keep your fingers wet. If your fingers aren't wet, the rice is gonna stick to your fingers. So get your fingers wet, and then you're gonna spread your rice out on your seaweed. And then I like to leave the edges probably like a half inch of rice away from the edges. It helps when you're rolling it to stay together better if you don't have rice all the way up to the edges. So just spread your rice out, nice and even. Now the thing about sushi is you can put whatever you want inside of it. If you like avocado, cucumber, carrots, scallions, cream cheese, you can do whatever you want inside. You can do all of those, you can do one, really whatever you want to do. And now also the good thing about making sushi at home is you can choose how much fish you put in it. A lot of times if you go out to a restaurant, you only have a little tiny piece of fish inside your roll. So here's our wahoo. Victor chopped up nice for us. So there's a piece of wahoo. And now when you're putting things inside your roll, we always chop everything based on the size of the roll. So this was a giant cucumber that we cut like perfect to fit inside the roll. So this one I'm gonna do cucumber. Do people like carrots and rolls?
Everything.
Okay, we're gonna do everything in this one. So we got cucumber. We only had baby carrots, so that's what we got going on here. I'd suggest getting big carrots. So we got baby carrots, a scallion. Now we're gonna do avocado. And you wanna line everything up on one side of the roll. And we'll even put cream cheese in this one. Everything nice and lined up. Now go wash your fingers. So now what you're gonna do is grab your bamboo roll in your saran wrap, and you're going to start to roll up your roll. And now you wanna make sure that your saran wrap doesn't get inside your seaweed, so you always wanna be holding onto your saran wrap. And you're going to just be squishing the roll nice and tight as you go. And just keep pulling your bamboo and your saran wrap up. And just keep pushing it together. And just keep going until it's completely rolled up. You want to make sure it's nice and tight. Now I have a lot of stuff in this roll, so this is going to be a fat roll. All right, here we go. Ta-da! Now another really important tip for this is you want a very, very sharp knife. And you want to make sure that you keep it clean. So after you cut a roll, clean it, because then it's going to make it a lot harder to cut the roll. All right, so now for the fun part. I don't use the ends. So I'm going to cut off like a half an inch. This is for the chef. And since this roll's so fat, I'm not gonna make them too thick. So they're about like a half inch pieces. And then again, I'm not gonna use this end. They tend to not get a bunch of stuff in it, so it's not really worth putting on the tray. And then there we go. There's your sushi roll. And now you make about 300 more. So now this roll I'm making is called an inside out roll. It's basically the exact same thing as the last one, but you roll it with the rice on the outside. I also sprinkled the rice with black sesame seeds for this. So spread out your rice and then flip it over so the seaweed side is now up. Make sure the saran wrap is under on the rice side. Add in all your ingredients and now roll the exact same way. I personally think these rolls take longer because you need the rice closer on one end so you don't see any seaweed on the outside. And they're stickier to roll, so it's a little harder. If I had time, I would have made more of these, but I think I only rolled 3 of these. See how you can see a line of seaweed on the outside? Make sure you get the rice all the way to the edge, and then that won't happen. There's a few ways to roll sushi, and I know some people only use half of a seaweed sheet, but this is how I taught myself to do it, and it works well for me. I'm in no ways calling myself a professional sushi chef. So going over a few of my most important tips would be: make sure your fingers are wet when spreading out the rice, put your bamboo roller inside of a plastic bag, and make sure you have a really, really sharp, clean knife. Now, I rolled all the sushi rolls myself, and Victor made a few other things while I was doing that. One thing was seared wahoo. We love lightly seared fish. Victor covered the wahoo in sesame seeds and had a pan on high heat with a little sesame oil in it. Once the pan is hot, you can put in your fish. They should cook for less than a minute on each side, and just keep turning the fish till the whole outside is lightly seared. The inside of the fish should still be raw. This is another time when a super, super sharp knife comes in handy to cut the fish. We always make nice thin slices, and oh boy, how delicious does that look? Victor also made homemade spicy mayo, which is just simply sriracha and mayo, and he also made homemade eel sauce, which is equal parts sugar, soy sauce, and mirin, heated in a pot till it becomes thick. We love to use this on all the rolls. It's so, so good. Earlier, I made what I like to call wonton boats. They're these wonton wraps that I place in cupcake sheets to get the perfect cup shape. I baked them with a little salt and olive oil for only about 9 minutes. Victor filled these up with some homemade poke. If you want to know how he made this delicious recipe, check out his Wahoo video I will have linked in the description. These are something new that I added to our sushi nights, and they're a huge hit. I definitely recommend trying them out. Victor also placed the poke over cucumber slices. For this, make sure your cucumber slices are cut thin, but not too thin where it's too difficult to pick up. I'm not going to lie, rolling this much sushi takes a very long time. But it's satisfying at the end to see what you made, and especially when you invite over a bunch of friends to enjoy it. I've made a lot of sushi videos in the past that are more detailed. If you want to check those out, I'll have them linked in the video description. Left out of all those plates, but we have a couple people who are coming late, so hopefully they can finish it up or you guys can take it home. What'd you guys think?
Come on, where's the energy?
Alright, these wonton whatever
that was my
thingies here with the Victor's eel sauce, unreal. It was so
his
good.
His seared stuff over here was
delicious. The mango salsa was delicious.
You got Mitchell
the poke bowls are good.
Eat sushi. Yeah. That's awesome.
Yeah, first sushi experience.
Something other than chicken and pizza.
Yeah, it was good.
What
did
you really think, good. Mitchell? First time ever actually having sushi.
It was good, man. I was a little skeptical at first, but I really liked it. It was really good.
There we go.
The mango salsa.
Better
the mango white claw. Pretty good.
Better than any sushi restaurant.
By far.
Ooh. And these two are big sushi people. Big I see the snaps. People.
Yeah. The best.
There we go. You killed it, babe. Ricky did a good
way
job.
Way to go, Brooke. Thank you.
I'm pretty sure I rolled 25 rolls of sushi all by myself.
You did?
And I think I did pretty good on time. Like, I think it maybe took me 3 hours.
I felt for you.
25 rolls in 3 hours. I guess that wasn't too bad. Yeah, it was a really fun night, and everything turned out really good.
Thanks for coming, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Also, don't forget to enter the Engel Cooler giveaway. Simply make sure you're subscribed, then go to englecoolers.com to pick out your favorite cooler and color up to an 80 quart and just comment that down below. Good luck and be watching to see if you won. Also, don't forget I'm also doing a giveaway on my Instagram. Make sure you're following me at Brookie Christ.